Malawi's President Lazarus Chakwera has decreed 3 days of national mourning after two members of his cabinet succumbed to COVID-19 on Tuesday. Local Government Minister Lingson Belekenyama and the Minister of Transport Muhammad Sidik Mia died in the capital Lilongwe. The two are the highest ranking public officials so far to succumb to the virus in Malawi. President Chakwera has said the government is considering declaring a state of emergency. To speak a little bit more about this, we're joined now by Malawi's Information Minister, Gospel Kazako. A very good evening to you, Minister. Thank you so much for speaking to us. Has there been any decision yet on whether a state of emergency is required?
Now, at the moment, what has been declared is a state of national disaster. After that, that will inform into a decision whether we are going to have the other declaration. But at the moment, it's just a state of national disaster. Look, we have lost two cabinet ministers in a space of 1 day and within the spacing of 2 hours. Just this morning at 8 o'clock, we lost the Honorable Minister of Local Government, Honorable Lingson Belekenyama. And then 2 hours later, we have also lost the Honorable Muhammad Sidik Mia, Minister responsible for transport. So it has been very, very hectic for us. It's a very, very sad day in Malawi. And the president had to come out to show leadership, and he is actually demonstrating very strong and decisive leadership.
Minister Kazako, what can you tell us about how long both ministers were ill, as in were they ill for some time, or did they succumb very quickly to the disease?
Yeah, it's an average of about 2 weeks when they were diagnosed with COVID-19. We thought they were going to pull through, but unfortunately they didn't manage to pull through. It's very, very sad indeed. In fact, we are almost a nation under siege. We're very sad, we're broken and devastated. But you see, we are a nation of character. We have a very, very strong character. We're going to fight this, and we're going to prevail, and we're going to win, because we are a nation full of champions, full of people who are very decisive and also have a very, very decisive leadership. And we know we're going to fight this pandemic, and certainly we're going to win.
Just looking a day ago at the number of confirmed cases, I think you were sitting at about 8,500 active cases at 2,300 and odds. What are the current figures, and how concerned are you about the spread of COVID-19 at the moment?
Most of the cases that we have now, the high percentage is one that has occurred between the 1st January to date. We believe that these have been motivated by the festival period, people coming into Malawi and wanting to have holidays. Of course, other Malawians also returning from other countries like South Africa, Zimbabwe, Zambia, and so on and so forth. So the numbers have really gone very high. Numbers of the people that have died, and also the people that are also spreading. I would give you a good example. For example, we had about 500 people, minus plus 500 people, were returning from South Africa. We took them to a camping site where we do testing. We tested them, and over 120 of them were actually positive, were COVID positive. I think that informs us that, you know, a good number of this negative aspect of the fight is being diluted by those that are coming from elsewhere. Because in Malawi here, on our own here, we managed to reach the numbers at certain times, we're actually at zero. We were doing very, very well, but the holidays have not assisted us. But still,
Just before you go on, Minister Kazako, I mean, just looking at the figures, and you'll correct me if I'm wrong, I believe you have about 17.6 outcomes that are under investigation, and you say you believe that a good number of those cases are from outside. Can you give us at least a figure that you have scientifically worked out, according to your medics, that this proportion of people have contracted COVID-19 within Malawi's borders, and this number has imported it, so to speak, according to your implication, into the country?
The one I can give you without being hypothetical is the one that I have mentioned to you, that we had over 500 people. We tested them, and over 120 people were positive.
Okay.
So that we are very, very sure.
All right. So that's with a total of over 9,000 cases cumulatively of COVID-19. Let's talk about resources. Yeah. What concerns do you have?
Come again?
Resources. What concerns do you have? Do you have adequate resources to at least monitor the virus and its spreading, hospitalization, ventilators, etc.? And also, perhaps to talk about vaccination, how far are you in that process yourselves?
The most important resource that we have at the moment is the confidence that we have in ourselves, the zeal to fight, and the sense of nationhood, where we are standing together to fight this pandemic. I think that's the most crucial resource in as far as we are concerned. But we're also looking for resources, monetary resources, and certain items. Of course, human resource, we also need that. This is why the president has declared the national state of disaster, so that using the instruments that are there, we should be able to start working with our partners like the United Nations, local companies that can make contributions to this fight. So talking of resources, yes, we need a lot of resources, but the first resource that we have as a country that believes in unity, because we are a very, very united country,
okay,
by the way. Very united. Yeah, so,
before we run out of time, Minister Kazako, what are the implications of that national state of disaster? Is there going to be a curfew? What restrictions will apply?
Tomorrow there is an emergency meeting. The president has directed that there be committees, and we are having to meet tomorrow. We'll come up with the tougher measures, certainly measures that are different from what we have now. Maybe we'll certainly have to restrict certainly freedoms because we have to look at the bigger picture. So tomorrow,
right,
before close of business, we should be able to make very key and capital announcements that will guide us in the fight against this pandemic. But we know we're going to prevail. That one, make no mistake, we're going to prevail. We are going to prevail.
Thank
We're
you
very
so
geared
much.
For this.
Thank you so much. And of course, wishing you all the best in that.